last day of the year, this last day of the year brings us to the presentation of the child Jesus in the temple. Okay? So, the Lord was brought by Our Lady and Saint Joseph to the temple in order to be presented to the Lord. It's not yet here, because in the Gospel, the long form is reserved for family to canvas. But here, we only have that part wherein Simeon prophesies about the child being the rise and the fall of many in Israel, a sign to be contradicted by many. A sign to be contradicted by many. Now, our Lord was brought to the temple in fulfillment of the law. And what was the law? Every firstborn male shall be consecrated to the Lord. Now, why consecrate the firstborn male? Well, of course, you all know it really came from the Exodus, wherein the firstborn male on the night of Exodus were all slaughtered by the angel of death, all except the ones living in the homes where the blood of the lamb, the sacrificed lamb, was smeared on the lintels of the door. Okay? Now, aside from that, why the preference for the firstborn male? Well, it is because the first of anything belongs actually to God. Okay? Inasmuch as God is the source of everything that we have and everything that we are. Okay? Inasmuch as God is the source of everything that we are and everything that we have, the least we can do is to offer Him the first of everything. For example, the morning after the Passover, you have the festival of the first fruits, wherein the first stalks of barley harvested from the fields are brought to the temple and waved in front of God. That was the first fruit. Or, for example, the first oil that comes out from crushed olives, yung unang oil nun, that automatically goes to the temple in order to light the lamps in the temple. They belong to God. Or the first animal goes to God, sacrifice. Therefore, also the firstborn son. Actually, we don't need to whack your brains out. Kasi up till now, it happens. Not really about God, but you know, how secular. Example, when people, young people, get employed for the first time and receive their first salary, okay, diba? They will give it to the person who meant the most to them. Yes, an act of gratitude. For example, a number of times, my boys in the convent who graduated, one day after leaving us for so long time, and then they deploy, they come back, one at a time. Father, peace come. Father, kaya sa labas. Lampera, lampera. No, dito, o bakit? Kasi Father, nakuha ko yung when these things happen to me, like, why get so, why get so mushy, I get so sensitive. Kasi it really meant, sa kanila, it really meant, Father, you know, I acknowledge that if it were not for your hand, I would not have graduated to be able to do this job. Now it happened to me a number of times. I feel so sentimental on these things. So you do that and transport that to God. The first fruit of everything I give to God. Actually, that is the logic of the low mass and the first hour of the year. That's my logic. So, besides that, the firstborn, the status of the firstborn is very important for the Jews. For example, Abraham, the book of Genesis, was complaining to God. Kasi, Lord, you blessed me with so much wealth, but you have never given me a son. So, who would inherit all of this? Paghati-hatihan ng mga alipin ko, my slaves will simply divide among themselves when I die. And so God said, no, Abraham, don't worry, I will give you a son. And so, in spite of their old age, Abraham and Sarah had a son. And that son was Isaac, who inherited everything. That's why the Muslims are very angry with the Jews. Because Ishmael got nothing, Isaac got everything, and Ishmael was the ancestor of the Arabs, and Isaac was the ancestor of the Jews. That's why it's sibling rivalry. Okay. Now, the firstborn son gets to inherit everything. He receives the blessing of his father in his own age. And that is why on his shoulders rested the immense responsibility of, number one, caring for the parents in their own age, and number two, caring for the welfare of his siblings. So, fine, you get to inherit everything. Wow, you better take care of my family and his family and their family. Okay? You take care of them. Kaya nga, in the eyes of his siblings, the eldest stands as a second parent. That's why when the eldest son speaks, when the eldest son speaks, he speaks with authority. Because it is the authority of the father, the parent. You remember that the story of the prodigal son? Hinati ni father yung inheritance to who? The younger one got in there as a squander, he was leaving, comes back, and then the father decides to create a feast, right? Why do you have a feast? The son of yours comes back after squandering your property, he comes back, and then you have a feast celebrating for him. You kill them, you slaughter the fattened calf. I couldn't even ask for a kid for me to feast with my friends. And what did the father tell him? You know that everything I have is yours. Bakit po sinisisi? Like, you never enjoy a king. Eh, yung ayaw na yun. It's there for your taking. It's yours already. Everything I have is yours. See the impact? Everything I have is yours. So don't complain. Okay? So, yun yun. So, Our Lady and Saint Joseph got the baby Jesus in the temple because the Lord was Mary's firstborn. Now here, let us make it very clear now that our Lord was Our Lady's firstborn did not mean that there was a second or a third or a fourth or a fifth child. It did not mean that because Our Lady was a virgin when she bore our Lord in her womb. It was by the power of the Holy Ghost. Without losing her virginity, she became a mother. And even after the birth, Our Lady remained to be a virgin because Saint Joseph recognized that Our Lady was the burning bush that God descended on her without destroying her virginity. So, St. Joseph had every right to claim Our Lady's virginity. After all, he is the husband of Our Lady. He had every right to do so, but St. Joseph abstained from it. Why? Because he recognized that Our Lady was sacred ground. God descended on her. And therefore, he would not interfere. Okay? So, he did not take what is his. Therefore, our Lord had no siblings. The brothers and sisters referred to by sacred scriptures were actually kinsmen and women. They were cousins, sons and daughters of another couple, definitely not of Our Lady, but close relatives of Our Lady or Saint Joseph. Therefore, our Lord was Our Lady's firstborn because it was He who opened the womb of the Virgin. And that makes Him firstborn. This was the reason why our Lord was brought by His parents to the temple in order to be presented to God. Because Jesus, our Lord, is the firstborn of Our Lady, therefore, He must be consecrated to the Lord. But remember that our Lord Jesus isn't just the Son of Mary. Our Lord is also Son of God. And our Lord is Son, the only begotten God. As our Lord Jesus is the only Son of the Blessed Virgin, He is also the only Son of the Father. The only Son of the Father. The God the Father did not have other offsprings apart from the one and only Son. Unlike Jupiter, He sired children, many women who became, and His children became demigods, right? But the real God, ay alam mo kung sino yung demon eh. Alam mo kung sino yung demon eh. Alam mo kung sino yung real God eh. Kasi kung si demon, okay, the false God, Jupiter, or Zeus, sire, mahilig niyang magkalatang lahi. But God only had one. So in His humanity, our Lord had a mother without a father. And this in His divinity, our Lord had a father without a mother. So in a way, God the Father is a virgin father. Our Lady is a virgin mother. So our Lord is the only begotten Son of God. Of course, but Father, do we not call God Father? Are we not children? Of course, we are children of God. That's the gospel. That's the first meaning today, di ba? Sabi niya, because you are sons, God said to speak of son your house by Abba, Father. But remember that our filiation is that of adoption. Okay? Like, so that we might receive the adoption of sons. What did it mean, Father? What did it mean? To be adopted and not, and we are not the natural children of God. It's very simple. Our nature and the nature of God are worlds apart. He is divine, we are not. Even with us being adopted by God, we will never become God. Yeah. And it, to me, ang comparison niya, men who's puso, like Gen Z people, they have pets and they call their sons or daughters. Gen Z, ako kaya, total ko is my son. And the third father of Cotton Boy. Also, Paul. Paul is my son. So, if you see boy there in the church, don't go there and kick him. No. Don't kick him. Don't do him harm because that boy is my son. But, look at me. Cotton Boy and Paul will always be dogs. They will never become human. And I will remain human and I'll never become a dog. You see what I mean?
Yes.
Okay. So, you transfer that to God and us. Our filiation is not natural, but a relationship of adoption. And that was very clear in today's first lesson. You receive a spirit of adoption. One who gives you the right to call God Abba, Father. So we do not call God Father in the same way that our Lord calls God Father. Kaya nga may abomali na doon, yung Our Father, we call the Lord's Prayer. That is not actually the Lord's Prayer. But it was the prayer Jesus taught. Because he will not address God, Father, in the same way that we call His Father, the Lord. Ibang level yun. Kaya nga, di ba, sabi kay Magdalene, do not touch me, call me, Father. I have not ascended to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God. But, to our God, to our Father. No, because His Father, His relationship with the Father is in a way so different from our relationship to His Father. Magkaiba. Okay? Magkaiba. So, it's different with our Lord, who is God from God, light from light, true God from true God, consubstantial with the Father. Which means, if the Father is God, our Lord is also God. If the Father is light, our Lord is also light. Being the Son of God, Jesus is true God. Being the Son of Mary, Jesus is true man. And that is why, if our Lord is the firstborn of Mary, we also can say, is the firstborn of God. Actually, St. Paul would say that, the firstborn of all creation, the firstborn from the dead. Okay? St. Paul said, the firstborn of all creation, and the firstborn of all the dead. What does it mean now that he is the firstborn of God? It means everything the Father owns belongs to him. Everything was created through him, and everything was created for him. And that would include you and me. Kasi yung naging masyadong tayo, ano yung center tayo sa humanity natin, to the point that we think that God created the world for us human beings. Wrong. God created the world for His only begotten Son. Tayo din, He created us for whom? He created us for His only begotten Son. He created us for His only begotten Son. Kaya nga, ututusin, that's what we say in the Gospel of Christmas Day. Kaya? Through Him, everything was created, and nothing came to be except through Him. And so, being the first one of God, this little boy is actually filled to reach. Which is an Elon Musk. Which is an anybody can think of. Because the entire universe is owned by him. In fact, when Our Lady and St. Joseph brought the DBGs to the temple, I'd like to wager that they did not realize that they were bringing into the temple the owner of the temple itself. Siguro, at the back of the mind for a lady, St. Joseph, presently is intended to fulfill a law. But little did they realize, they were bringing into the temple the very owner of the temple himself. And there, the owner of the temple was met by his servants, who were Simeon and Anna. Okay? And, Simeon and Anna were servants of God because they stayed in the temple. They prayed and fasted night and day for many, many years. That was in this gospel. They prayed and fasted many days and nights. Literally stayed at the temple night and day. Why? They were waiting for the owner to come back. And when the owner came back, they recognized him. It was the Holy Spirit who told, oh, this is the owner of the house. This is the owner of the temple. And Simeon not only recognized God coming in the temple, Simeon also recognized the immense responsibility being placed on the shoulders of this child. And what would that responsibility be? It would be the task of saving all people. Jesus is the salvation God has prepared for all nations. My eyes have seen the salvation. salvation you have prepared for all the peoples. That Jesus is the light that will guide the Gentiles and will give glory to the people of Israel. Jesus was destined for the rise and the fall of many in Israel. That a person's rising or falling will depend on how they will respond to the Lord Jesus. If they reject the Lord Jesus, then they will be condemned. If they accept the Lord and believe in Him and surrender to His laws and fulfill them, then they will be saved. And you know, it's a sign coming from God and will be contradicted by many. Contradicted by many. Kaya mahirap maging panganay. In the Lord's case, mahirap maging panganay. Why? Kasi, yes, He may have authority in heaven and earth too. But before He can claim that authority, He must first be rejected and be brought to the wood of the cross. He had to be rejected and brought to the wood of the cross. Upon His shoulders rested the immense responsibility of saving people whom He would call His brothers and sisters. And so, our Lord Jesus, becomes a sign of salvation and also the reason for the condemnation of many. Kaya nga, you are more than just a cute little baby in the manger. More than that, your salvation or your condemnation will depend on that little boy. Whoever believes in Him will not perish, but will have eternal. God sent not His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. O Mary, conceive without sin.